Hey guys, some exciting news that I wanted to share with you about the next update. So as you saw at the beginning of this video, in the next update we are going to get a new feature called Operation. So what exactly is Operation? Operation is going to be a way for players to get more resources, things like more gold, more silver, power cells, components, and in some cases we even get entire items. So how does this all work? I think the best way to really explain this is to hop on over to the Battle Reward Crates, because it's very similar to this in many ways. So as many of you know, when you play a game, you get honor points, right? So when you get that, you progress from, one crate to the next, and you kind of follow this timeline. And in the case of this account, which is in Champion League, once you get to the Champion Crate, you get silver, power cells, boosters, and components. And then, once you achieve that, the whole thing kind of loops all the way back to the start private crate, and the whole process starts again. So now that we kind of understand that, I'm going to show you some screenshots here of the whole operation feature. Okay, so the first thing you're going to notice at the bottom of your screen is a button called Operation. Before I kind of get into the whole thing, each operation period is going to last for about 2 months, I believe they said. And, every 2 months, I believe it's going to reset. So that's how they are going to do that. And based on the second screenshot that you guys are seeing right now, we have some sort of a battle pass system. So this is kind of the reason why I wanted to explain the whole battle reward crate things. Because you can see here on the top row, which is the one that's free. So this is sort of the free pass. You basically play the game, you get operation experience points, and you progress along this timeline, except it doesn't loop. You have continuous prizes up until, I think it's level 70 is the highest level. I'm not sure if they're going to change that. I'm not sure if that's set in stone just yet, but the last image that I saw, them show me, actually showed level 70. So that's kind of how it's going to work. You can get all the way there, not paying anything. And then if you do decide to get a gold pass, which is sort of like a VIP thing, it's going to cost $15 is what they mentioned, or around there. And you can see the pricing is slightly different. So, if you decide to get the gold pass, instead of getting 2 million silver for level 19, you get 4 million. Instead of getting the Griffin at level 20, you get a special edition Griffin called the Scavenger Griffin. And the same thing kind of happens with gold. Now, one thing that you could actually do with this, and I was kind of reading their notes, you could actually farm the entire 70 levels for free. And then at that point, if you decide to get a gold pass and you purchase it, you get all the other items that you would have gotten if you had got the gold pass from level 1. So let's just say, for example, you were playing for free up until level 21 and you got the 100 gold. At that point, you decide, well, you know what, I kind of like that special edition Griffin. I'm going to get a gold pass. So you purchase it. Once you purchase that, you get 2 million additional silver, you get the special edition Griffin and an additional 100 gold. So I believe this is how it's going to work. And on top of that, every day you are going to get a daily challenge as well, which is going to be included. So the whole daily task thing that we have in the game currently is going to be, I think, implemented into this system, I believe, based on, what I'm reading. Obviously, as you can see here, not all the rewards are final, so they're still making adjustments, still trying to work things out in getting this update to us. But I kind of like where they're going with this. And there's also another way which you could get more operation experience points, and that would be through the premium. But let me know what you guys think of this idea. Maybe you have other ideas to actually improve on this that you've seen, other games kind of do. I'd love to know your opinions on that, and I can always forward that through to Pixonic. And what I'm going to do now is I'm also going to show you short clips of the Scavenger Griffin in 3D view, as well as a new, like, Aljung model, which I actually really like that one. It looks really, really cool. And also some pilots which are going to come with this update. But otherwise, I think that pretty much covers everything that I wanted to share with you as far as this update goes. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed, consider subscribing. Until the next video, I'll catch you guys later.